Why are you excited to be doing Turner Classic Movies, The Essentials?
Well, I'll tell you, two reasons. The opportunity to do something with you, because you and I have never done anything except when you were a guest on my old show, which was always great. One of those moments we would look forward to, and everybody enjoyed it. And you were on 1,000 times. I've seen every old movie ever made. And when you get to be a certain age, you have to pick a topic and a demographic that match up where people won't talk to you. So that's why I'm here.
Now, what of these films that you've chosen are one of your favorites, would you say?
Well, I think the best of the bunch is Lost Weekend. And if I had decided to have a career in film, and by the way, the opportunities were there, I would want to be Billy Wilder. I marvel at the spectrum of films that he was responsible for, writing, directing, on and on. So I think Lost Weekend, and it's so hyperbolic, and Ray Milland just couldn't be sneakier, couldn't be creepier, couldn't be more desperate. So they're all well-made films, but I think this is my favorite.
Now, do you have a personal connection to any of the films that you've seen?
I used to be a heavy drinker. Right. I used to be an alcoholic.
I had a feeling.
So that would be a connection to Lost Weekend. And I had a few Lost Weekends, but boy, not represented the way Billy Wilder represents Ray Milland in that particular film. And James Dean, I have a personal connection to, in that I'm fond of racing. He was fond of racing. He and I are both from Indiana. Both of us died young. And I guess I have the most questions about East of Eden. I have nothing.
You're curious about it.
I'm very curious about it. The first most obvious question is the behavior of James Dean. Not only is he a scene stealer, he steals the entire movie. The movie becomes so secondary. And I'm wondering if they're dealing with the Tasmanian devil every day on the set, how the other actors felt about scene after scene after scene being upstaged by the kid.
I think the thing we can both safely say is thank God you weren't on the set of East of Eden. Who the hell knows what would have happened? You might have broken a chair over Jimmy Dean's head.